Good morning, my dear students of class 6th. Welcome to another session of English class. Today I am going to explain you poem number 6, The Wonderful Words, from your Honeysuckle book. So do you know, my dear children, how we human beings are different from other creatures? Yeah, we are different from them. The way of eating, sitting, the way we talk, above all the way we use words, ability to use language, and how we talk with other people. This makes us different from them. Can you imagine the world without language? What will happen when there will be no language? No words to express your feeling, thoughts, emotions, or your ideas. Human life revolves around the language, that is the means of communication. So this poem, The Wonderful Words, is written by Mary O'Neill. She expressed the importance of words, importance of language. So before starting the poem, I will tell you the intro of the poem. So this poem is all about the role and importance of language and the language skill to shape the ideas of the mind. All people think and speak. It's God's special gift to man. So let's enjoy this poem. Before explanation of the poem, let me read out the poem so that you will learn to pronounce the words properly. So stanza number 1. Never let a thought shrivel. Shrivel means to crush, to press, and die for want of a way to say it. For English is a wonderful game, and all of you can play it. All that you do is match the words to the brightest thoughts in your head so that they come out clear and true and handsomely groomed. Groomed means to clean, to polish, and fed. Fed means to satisfy. For many of loveliest things have never yet been said. Now let me explain you the given lines. Never let a thought shrivel and die for want of a way to say it. So here the poet means sometimes we have ideas in our mind, but we are not able to express that idea. We are not able to share our ideas because we don't have words to express it. Maybe it happens with you also, my dear children. Hence, we have a thought, we have an idea, but we don't share with anyone else. So poet is saying that you should not let your thoughts die in your mind. You should have the way to express your thoughts. How can you say those thoughts? So don't let your thoughts die in your mind. Next lines, for English is a wonderful game. Here, wonderful game means it's a wonderful language, that is marvelous language. And all of you can play it, means all of you can express your language, feeling, thought, ideas. Not only English, all the languages are beautiful. So the words make it beautiful, and one should know the art of using it. Moving to the next lines. All that you do is match the words to the brightest thoughts in your head. The poet here means that if you have brightest thoughts in your mind, you should speak that out. You can express that ideas, but your words must match with your ideas. Whatever you think, speak that. Sometimes you are thinking something else and speaking out something else. You should speak out what you think, and it must be wonderful, marvelous, clear, true, and handsomely groomed and fed. for many of the loveliest things have never yet been said. So, my dear children, when you speak the words, it must be clear. You have to think first. Before you speak, you must groom it. Means you must get it ready, cleaned. Your words must be cleaned. As you know, once you speak anything, it cannot be taken back. And what you think, it must affect others and must keep in their memories. There are so many thoughts, emotions, feelings, and have not been expressed yet by many people because they don't find appropriate words, means proper words to express that ideas. Into the last stanza, words are the food and dress of thought. They give it its body and swing. So here, poet means that words give us the power to express our feelings and emotions. Here, dress means proper words are liked by everyone. That's why poet is saying that choose your words appropriately so that it must not hurt others. They give it its body and swing. So the poet is saying that words give our thoughts, ideas, its body, means base to our thought, what we want to say and express. Besides providing body, words also help us to swing, that is to move to and fro. And everyone's longing today to hear some fresh and beautiful things. So here poet means everyone is longing, means curious or eager today to hear something new, fresh and beautiful ideas. Only words can free a thought from its prison behind your eyes. So here the poet is saying our thoughts, ideas are imprisoned, means locked up behind our eyes. So what is behind our eyes? That is our mind. And who can free it? Only words can free our thoughts, ideas from our mind. So words can give wing to our thoughts. Now reading an explanation of last two lines. Maybe your mind is holding now a marvelous new surprise. So here the poet is saying, maybe your mind is holding an idea which can be very wonderful. So you can express your thoughts, ideas through words. So you must have art of using it. Your language must be perfect. My dear children, this was the poem. I hope you have understood and enjoyed the poem. This poem gives us a beautiful message that words have magical power. They bring happiness and can change the mind of anyone. Your words must be clear, beautiful, perfect, so that it can affect others, so that they can keep in their memories. So thank you all, my dear children. God bless you all.